Hello everyone, in this video lecture we are going to study about PHP superglobal variables, right? So first of all, we should know what is superglobal variable. Superglobal variable, that means some predefined variables that are available in PHP, right? So we can access them, they are always accessible, right? We can access them from anywhere, from any function, any class or file, right? Without having to do anything special, right? We need not to do, like, we need not to write any special code for that, right? That are accessible, right? And regardless any scope, right? There is no scope that for that super global variables, right? So some super global variables that are readily available in PHP that are $global, $_server, $_request, $_post, $_get, $_files, $_cookie, $_session. Now first we are going to study about that $globals variable, right? Now $globals is a PHP super global variable which is used to access global variable from anywhere in PHP script, right? So it can be either in the function or in the method, or you can use outside the function, right? Now how it will be stored? So PHP stores all the global variables in an array, right? So that array name is, for this it's a $globals array, right? So $globals and with the index. Now what is the index? So that variable name, that is your index, right? So with that index you can access that global variable, right? So now we are going to see one example for global variable, right? Now in this example, first of all I am starting my XAMPP control panel, right? So I am starting the Apache. There is no need to start MySQL because right now I am not dealing with the database, right? So only Apache. Then I am creating one file. So for that I have to go to C drive, XAMPP server, then htdocs. Here I need to create one file. So I'm creating one file, and that file should be PHP file because I have to deal with the PHP. So I'm creating one PHP file. I saved that file as a glow_example.php glow_ex.php, right? So I'm creating one file, it's a PHP file, so I have to start it with bracket question mark PHP and end with question mark bracket. Then I'm taking one variable $x that is equal to 40 and $y that is equal to 25. Now I'm creating one function, that is function add. In this function I'm creating one global variable, so $global z that is equal to $global x plus $globals y. Now outside this function, I'm just calling this function, that is add, and after this I'm printing. That means for that I need to use echo, right? So echo $z, right? Here z is my global variable that is defined inside global add function, right? Now I'm opening the localhost, that is localhost 80, port number 80. This is my dashboard. Now I'm writing the URL for that glow glo.ex, right? glo.ex.php. glow_ex.php. So I'm writing this glow_ex.php. Now I got my answer 65, that is 40 plus 25, that is 65. Now I'm creating another function here, 40 plus 25, that is 65. Here my $z is outside the function, but that is a global variable so that I can access it outside the function also. Now I'm creating another function, that is function sub for the subtraction, and I'm doing the subtraction, right? So again I'm creating one more global variable, let us say m, right? That is $globalx - $globaly. Again I'm calling that function and echo $m. Now I refresh that page, so I get 65 and 15, right? There is no space in between, so I am adding break. So for that, echo in double quotes br/, and if I refresh, then I got the answer 65 and 15, right? My both the variables, that is inside the function, both the global variables that were inside the function $m and $z, then also I got the answer, right? So that is $globals. The another global variable, that is $_server. Now $_server is a PHP super global variable which holds the information about headers, paths, scripts and locations. In $_server, we are having it is again an array of $_server with a predefined index, right? So for that index we are having, that is php_self, right? Now php_self, it will return the file name of currently executing script. Whatever script is executing, it will return that file name, right? Next we are having, that is $_server server name, right? Now it will return the server name, now host server name, right? Whatever host we are working on right now, in current example which we are going to see, and that we are working on localhost, so it will return localhost, right? Let us see the example. In this example I'm already prepared one file, that is server_ex.php. So let us see, in this I'm having $_server php self, right? I'm just echoing, printing that part, then $_server server name, and the third one is http host, right? So if I run this, right, so first it will return server_ex, right? So php self means it will return the currently running script name, right? Next I'm getting localhost, right? So first it is $_server server name, and second one, that is a http host name. Now server name will return the server name, right now we are working with a localhost, and http server, that is also return the server name, right? That is again we are having localhost, right? The next global variable we are having, that is $_request. Now this variable is used, that is a PHP super global variable that is used to collect the data after submitting any HTML form, right? So whenever user submit the data by clicking on submit, right, so that form data is sent to the file specified in the action attribute, right? In a form tag we are having one attribute, that is action, right? So in action attribute, right, so at that time the data will be stored in $_request array, right, with the index as a name. We are writing in each and every element, right? Suppose we are having input type, so input type text box we are having name, so suppose that name is fname, right? So it will be stored in $_request in a bracket fname, that index will be replacing the name in my input field, right? So let us take one example. Now in this example, we are going to create one PHP file with the form, right? So that is request underscore req underscore example dot php. In this file, I'm going to create HTML form. So I need to start with HTML slash HTML. In the body part, I'm not writing head part right now, so directly body slash body. I'm creating one form, that is form. I'm not writing any attribute inside the form element. If I mention action, then it will be forwarded to that particular page, but right now I'm not writing it, so that can be forwarded to the same page, right? Then I'm having one field name, that is input type text, the name of that label, that is f name, right? So that we can access this input type text with the f name, right? Now I'm creating one submit button, so that is input type submit. And the name will be submit only. Now I want to access this file. I'm writing the placeholder so that it will be easy for the user to what to enter. So enter your name. Now if I open this in browser, so that's a localhost req underscore example dot php. That is my simple form without any effect. It's just a GUI, right? There is nothing on submit button. Now I need to create one PHP, right? Right now I'm writing it in a same file. That's why I have not mentioned that form action, right? So that it can be directly directed to the same page only. The same page can be accessible. So dollar name is equal to, now I'm fetching the value from that form, right? So dollar underscore request f name, right? Now this f name comes from the name of your input type text, right? Input type text, you're having that name f name, so I have to write same as it is, right? So it can be accessible. So whenever user submit that button, it will be stored in this array, right? And I'm just displaying echo dollar name. Now if I refresh, it will generate one notice, that is undefined index, because till now I have not submitted that. So if I submit this, so it's a Kaya, right? So again, if I want that if user submit without any name, then it will be welcome user, and if there is a name, that is then welcome whatever name, right? So I'm writing, that is empty dollar name. Empty dollar name will return, it will be set when your dollar name field is empty, right? Dollar name variable is null, right? So for that I'm writing welcome user. In a else part, I'm writing echo. In this echo, I'm updating this welcome. I'm concatenating that with dollar name variable. So welcome with a dot I can concat, right? And this should be in the front part, right? So if I save and run this, it's a welcome Kaya. If I refresh this properly, still it will generate an error, right? That is a notice that I'll show you how to omit, right? So right now it's a welcome user, and if I enter the name, that is Kaya, then it's a welcome Kaya. Now for that notice period, that notice message, right, how can I remove that, right? So it will, PHP, the script will be run one by, execute one by one. So first of all, that submit button is not pressed, right? So I can check it via is set button. So it's a is set dollar underscore request submit. So if the submit button has been pressed, then it will be set, otherwise it will be zero, right? So if I refresh this, right, if I completely refresh this, so by default if I press on submit, there is no notice. If I press submit, there's a welcome user, and if I enter any name, that is Kaya, so welcome Kaya, right? So with the help of isSet variable, right, it's not variable, isSet method, right, we can check whether the particular button is pressed or not, right? So we can simply like omit that notice, right? I think you all are clear with dollar underscore request, right? Now my next super global variable, that is dollar underscore get and dollar underscore post, right? Now that are similar to dollar underscore request, right? This both are used to collect the form data after submitting any HTML form, right? But with the method name, right? So if I have written the method that is equal to post, I can use dollar underscore post. And if I have already written the method that is equal to get, then I can use dollar underscore get. Right, dollar underscore request, that is a general common super global variable, so that I can use anywhere whether the method is get or post, or I have not written any method. In the previous example, I have not mentioned any method, right? So at that time also I can use dollar underscore request, and I can use that variable dollar underscore request with any of the get or post method, right? But for this particular dollar underscore get, that can be used with the get method only, and dollar underscore post, that can be used with the post method only, right? So I think you all are clear about this. For the example of this too, you just go through the previous example, right? Replace the dollar underscore request with the dollar underscore get, and add the method is equal to get in the form attribute, right? So that you can refresh this, right, save that particular code and execute that and see what is the difference between these two, what will be the result, right? Similar way, you can use the dollar underscore post, right, and replace that dollar underscore request with dollar underscore post, right, and add that method is equal to post, right, and then execute and see the difference between this three, that is dollar underscore request, dollar underscore get, and dollar underscore post. Now next three variables, super global variables that we are having, is dollar underscore files, dollar underscore session, and dollar underscore cookie, that we are going to discuss in our next video, right? So I think till now whatever I have explained, you all are clear about this, right? Thank you.